Hello everyone, this is Pal Ponder on Weather coming at you with another update. In this update, we're going to be talking about a significant severe weather outbreak. So before I do get started, if you do like weather related content, please subscribe to my channel as I will upload daily updates to keep you ahead of the storm. And I do ask you to share this video with your friends and family on social media, right? So let's get started. We got a lot to talk about. Here's the latest satellite picture as of this morning, March the 24th. And it's basically been two systems. This first system is moving out. It's lifting up north this morning and up in Canada. And back behind it, you can actually see that comma-shaped swirl extending all the way down to the coast where they had some very heavy rain yesterday in Louisiana. And we have a very active subtropical jet still active. And then our attention turns to the Four Corners regions where they're having some snow right now in New Mexico. And that'll extend into the Texas Panhandle as well later on the day. And then back behind it, yes, we got some very heavy rain into Washington and Oregon. A lot of this is transferring to snow in the higher elevations, especially as you get into Idaho. So let me kind of walk you through how this is going to play out. It looks like we have a very active two-day time frame. Here's the latest HRRR model. This first system is lifting northward as of this morning, getting into the day on Wednesday. That's going to be dumping some snow into parts of northern Minnesota, extending into Canada. But yes, like I mentioned, all of our attention turns out here to this second system that's dumping some snow right now into parts of Albuquerque as well as Santa Fe. That's extending into the Texas Panhandle, and that's going to make a beeline. You see the low here? That's going to make a beeline towards Texas later on the day as we get into the overnight into Texas by around 6 o'clock time frame. That's going to have enough lift in the atmosphere for more showers and thunderstorms to break out over Texas. And again, on the backside, that secondary low will start to really get its act together and start really taking a beeline towards Texas and eventually get into the southeast for another significant severe weather outbreak. So as we take you through, here's the latest Storm Prediction Center. They've actually upgraded this from yesterday. I was fully expecting this. So now we have a slight risk that encompasses Austin, Waco, Dallas, getting into Wichita Falls. All these areas are going to be under the gun for basically 6 o'clock later in tonight into the overnight. For severe weather. I mean, all three modes are expected. We've got hail, high winds, and a very low tornado threat as this extends eastward, and just a marginal threat if you live in areas like into San Antonio, and not too bad in places like into Houston as this continues to shift off. So, but it looks like there's some very heavy rain. I mean, there are the amounts of 1 to 2 inches could fall just in the next 12 to 24 hours into Texas as this lifts off. So definitely be on the lookout for some quarter-size hail, some 60-mile-per-hour winds. And yes, there is always that isolated tornado threat along that line of thunderstorms. And it looks like there's going to be two waves of opportunity. So essentially from like 6 o'clock to midnight. And then there's a secondary wave, like I mentioned on the backside low, that's going to be coming through midnight into the overnight hours as well. So it should be a bumpy evening in a good chunk of Texas with a lot of lightning and thunder. I'm talking 3 o'clock in the morning time frame too as well. So it's going to keep you up. So as this extends moving forward into Thursday, that's when it really starts to get its act together and starts to really intensify. It's going to split. There's two lows. This is going to lift northward, and there's a secondary low to the south. That's going to be dumping some very heavy rain and set the stage for a significant, unfortunately, severe weather outbreak for a lot of the same areas that got hit last week. So let me kind of walk you through. Here's the latest from the Storm Prediction Center, and as expected, this was upgraded, in fact, to a moderate risk for severe weather. So if you live in areas in the red shaded area, into Birmingham, Alabama, Jackson, Mississippi, Huntsville, getting into Tuscaloosa, getting into Decatur, these areas are going to be under the gun of the most significant threat for severe weather. And then out in the outskirts into Memphis, into Nashville, into Chattanooga, Clarksville, and much of Tennessee are still going to be under the gun for that significant severe weather threat as well. As you're under an enhanced risk, these areas are all going to be lifting up to the northeast. So down to the south is a little bit lesser threat as you get into New Orleans and places into the Florida Panhandle as well, as this main energy source will be lifting northeastward as we get into the day. But yeah, this whole area, I mean, this looks like an avocado, right? You never want to be in the core of the avocado, because that's the highest fuel of severe threat. And unfortunately, underneath that, that's your highest tornado risk as well. So right now we're looking at a 15% of tornadoes in this zone. I mean, last week we were looking at 45% in some of these areas. So I mean, but we're still about 30 hours realistically from this event hitting, like say, getting its act together. So yeah, I mean, this could easily probably get bumped up a little bit more, because I mean, it's a lot of these parameters are really high. I'll show you here in a little bit. So a lot of the signs are pointing to another significant outbreak in a lot of the same areas. They just unfortunately got hit last week. It may be a little bit further north. So don't take your guard down in western Tennessee, because I do feel like you'll be a lot more impacted from this storm that you did last storm. So if you're anywhere in this area, you definitely need to have a weather radio handy. I do have one in the description in the link below that you can buy. I know several people actually ordered it yesterday, so I appreciate it. So yeah, I mean, definitely the main thing is to keep you safe. I mean, we're here to save lives, so you need to take this thing seriously, because there is going to be a significant threat, especially if you live in the red shaded areas, for severe weather. So you need to take every warning seriously, especially by Thursday, as this continues lifting off to the northeast. Here's your CAPE values. Here's your convective available potential energy in the atmosphere. We're still looking at 2,000, 2,500, upwards to almost 3,000, maxing out at 3,500. So this is a significant threat. There's going to be a lot of energy in the atmosphere in Mississippi and Alabama. And like I mentioned, this extends into western Tennessee, gets into parts of Kentucky as well, even southern Illinois. So this will this whole shift will shift northward. So if Louisiana, the Florida Panhandle, even parts of Georgia are going to be extended into the higher threat. So yeah, this whole area, this is the most significant threat in parts of Mississippi into Alabama. This is the zone, especially like into western Tennessee. This is really kind of the favorite area of the most highest threat. But even though if you're not in this zone, it doesn't mean you can't get anything, you know, a significance of either. So this whole area needs to be on high alert for a possible, you know, definitely a severe weather outbreak. Because, man, look at these tornado parameters. I mean, some of these are off the chart. It only goes to 10. I mean, this is a 16. I mean, this runs every, you know, 3 hours here, 3 hour time frame. So, but yeah, this, I mean, when you're looking at parameters, you know, kind of like off the chart, that's really concerning in this area. So that definitely means that this is a significant threat in this zone. So, and these could be long track tornadoes. I mean, there's a lot of updraft with the system. The bulk shear is very high. Every parameter that we look at is high. I mean, so that's why a lot of the ingredients are coming together for a severe weather outbreak. Here's your supercell composite index. I mean, you know, when this goes to, you know, looking at, you know, 20s and 25s. So yeah, these are some higher, you know, potentials of supercell thunderstorms with large hail, damaging winds, and that tornado threat is fairly significant. So do take this system seriously. Now, let's go back. I mean, we talked about the Southern Oscillation Index really starting to get inactive, and we came on this channel about a month ago and started making the call of it really turning south. This was literally February 23rd, and this was a two-week lag time, but is continuing to take a nosedive. And what happened was that gave us a signal of that subtropical jet really starting to get its act together. So we knew going forward that parts of the south and the southeast were going to get above average rainfall, because the SOI index was definitely implying that as it lifted more out of a weak La Nina into more of an end zone neutral pattern. And that's exactly what we've been seeing. Here's the rainfall just over the last 30 days. I mean, it's been a significant uptick in a lot of the central U.S. and getting into the southeast. And as that SOI continues to take a nosedive and that trajectory down further south, and again, a two-week lag time, this only tells you that these low-pressure systems will continue down to the south, and this conveyor belt of systems, it seems like every, you know, 3 or 4 days, unfortunately, looks to continue for the south. So that's what we have to look forward to, because that's some of the parameters. It's what's telling us it's going to continue to happen. So as that same system moves out by Friday, getting into Friday night, they will take a sigh of relief down here in these areas, and the cleanups will begin, and they'll start assessing the damage. But as this continues to lift up, it'll dump some heavier rains into Pennsylvania, get into New York, get into Vermont, New Hampshire, into Maine, as this secondary low will dump, again, more snow for parts of the Rockies, getting into parts of Denver again. And as we continue, that same shift will, by Friday, it's a lot lesser threat of severe weather, but again, it's at least a marginal risk of severe weather, that some of these storms could be a little dicey getting along the coast as that same system continues lifting off into the northeast. So places like into Memphis, Virginia Beach, and the Carolinas, and Norfolk, some of these could produce, you know, strong to some of these could be severe thunderstorms. So definitely be on the lookout for that. But it's a marginal risk for those areas. But as this continues the day on Sunday, we do see a little bit colder air coming in from to the northeast. That'll transfer some of this to snow and to the parts of New England, getting into Vermont, New Hampshire, especially as we get into Maine. But again, by Sunday, going into Monday, you see that southern jet. I mean, here's the low pressure. I mean, it's just like almost like a conveyor belt of moisture. Every couple of days, we have another system coming across that will be starting to activate more rain, especially as we get into Monday. And this along the south here, as that active subtropical jet looks to continue for this foreseeable future. And here's the rainfall for the next 5 to 6 days, just through the 29th. And you can definitely see they've already had a lot of rain in parts of the south, and they're going to be adding to those. So flooding is a huge concern on top of the severe weather as well. So when they look at these, you know, anywhere from 4 to 6 inches in a good chunk of Louisiana, Mississippi, and Alabama, parts of Georgia, extending into the Florida panhandle as well. Florida looks dry for the next 6 days. They will miss out on much of this for a good chunk of Florida. And this will continue lifting northeast. So there's your precipitation over the next 5 days. And yes, we have that active atmospheric river again into the Pacific Northwest, into Washington and Oregon. That looks to continue as well. And here's your snow. So like I mentioned, there's about a 2-day window for the northeast could get some snow out of this deal, the 29th and the 30th. And it's definitely still implying that, especially into Maine, we could be looking at some very heavy snow out of the system as some colder air creeps in from the north as this same system will continue to lift up. So that's looking like a Monday, Tuesday time frame. So we'll continue to keep our eye on this. But, this is the third or fourth day in a row that's actually showing that's, especially like if we get into Maine and Vermont, New Hampshire, could pick up some snow out of this on the backside as that colder air as it ends March. So hey, I appreciate you guys watching. Do like this video. Definitely leave your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to catch the latest update where I protect you before and after the storm.